Today, Ski Sunday rides the mountain railway to the Eiger. Switzerland staged the second of the downhill classics, just 7 days after celebrating their Kitzbühel success in Austria. Kitzbühel last week and now Wengen, this unique and historic ski town 4,000 feet up in the Alps. Now to get here, you either come up by train or, if you're ambitious enough, ski across and down from Grindelwald. And it's here that we have another of the World Cup's great races. This one is the oldest and the longest in the sport. It's the Laberhorn. Unlike Kitzbühel, where it was the helicopter ride to the top, you start here on platform one. And no matter who you are, it's load up and grab a seat on the World Cup Ski Commuter Special.
Morning.
Morning.
The training runs here have produced mixed fortunes. Peter Wiernsberger is bearing the scars of a big fall, but his Austrian teammate Armin Assinger is in hospital with leg injuries and out of the forthcoming World Championships. Five others are also out after training mishaps. For those who've come through, these are the most relaxing moments they'll get as they ride up to Kleine Scheidegg station. From here it gets steeper as they make the way to the Laberhorn start, over 7,000 feet up in the Swiss Alps. Well, that journey up to the top by train and T-bar takes almost half an hour. When they race the course, they'll hope to complete the 2.5 miles or so in less than 2.5 minutes. And you couldn't get a more impressive backdrop to it all than this, could you? The Eiger and the famous North Face. Now, the racers get a very special view of this as they take the hunch off. That's the biggest jump on the course shortly after the start. And one man is racing here for only the second time in his career, but he is among the favorites. He's Mark Giardelli, the Austrian who races for Luxembourg. He's trained and managed by his father, Helmut. And last week, he won the first downhill of his career in Kitzbühel, of all places. He's also won 3 races in Slalom and Giant Slalom. Without any doubt, he's the top performer of the season.
I prepared very strong and very especially this autumn for this season. I trained very hard physically and also mentally, and so I think it was the base was better than the years before for this season.
Jean-Claude Killy is the legend Giardelli is being compared to. Killy was the only man until now to have won downhill, slalom and giant slalom races in the same season.
I think especially the material improved since that time, since 20 years ago. And also when you compare the times, Killy skied in Wengen here, he skied about a little more than 3 minutes, and now we ski less than 2.5 minutes on the same course. But the preparation of the downhill was completely different, and there were a lot of more moguls on from the top to the finish. It was much more strong to ski the downhill 20 years ago, but it was much slower too. Maybe less dangerous than now, maybe more interesting, but it's very hard to make a comparison.
Like Kitzbühel last week, we have 2 downhills here at Wengen in 2 days. This is Giardelli on the first of the 2 races. He was drawn number 5, and before very long, those who'd gone before him knew they were going to be beaten. Giordelli was superb. The further down the mountain he went, the faster he went. Any slight mistakes were countered by brilliant compensation. Into the ice of the S. And then the jump where Müller fell badly years ago. And Giordelli breaks the Laverhorn course record by nearly 1.5 seconds, 2.5 miles in 2:26.54. No one got near him until Marcus Vosmar of West Germany, whose only downhill win ever was here 2 years ago, began to make everyone watch the clock. Dead level with Giardelli. If Vosmar could go just 1/100th faster over this last section, he'd produce an even bigger story. But there it was. Vosmar had lost half a second over the last 20 seconds of the mountain. Giardelli had the first of the two downhills here, 6 days after winning at Kitzbühel. For the first time this season, and for the first time in 7 downhills, Austria failed to get a man in the top three. Peter Wernsberger, after his training fall, was fifth. That was Austria's best. A former Wengen champion had a different story to tell that evening. An ice pack covered the left hand of Switzerland's Peter Müller. He'd fallen just after the big Hunschoff jump.
Yeah, I had a very good line at the top of the course, top part, and was very fast and jump in the Hunschoff. Then I was flying down, and I liked to jump very good to Minch County, and I had a bad jump, and then in the turn right to the little bridge, I was coming in the ski. And then I fell out and I came up, but then it was very bad outdoor and I fell in the nets down the Minch country.
Herman Zubrigen, without a win so far this season, had considered not starting here. There were reports that he was tired or ill. He finished eighth, but obviously exhausted. Had he got a reason for what was going wrong?
No, it's difficult to explain. Sometimes a little bit change what you need for to win, but what I see is I this year I have some problems with the feeling in the downhill. I cannot exactly feel the same thing like last year. Last year I had always a good position with my body, and this year I cannot really ski really in my limit. I couldn't find the limit.
But that's what everyone has to do now. The second Wengen race, the official Laverhorn Championship. Vosmar at number two, followed by Wernsberger. Müller will race number six before Giardelli. And Zubrigen will go at number 11. Ahead of all of them, this marathon course, 4,185 meters. A skiing cameraman, followed by a helicopter, shows us what it's like to ski the Laverhorn. The Hunschoff, the Hound's Tooth, the narrow gap in the rocks with the biggest jump, just above the railway line. So far, you've done no more than a quarter of the run. In places, as you swoop down the mountain at speeds that can reach 85 miles an hour, the course becomes very narrow. Only the tradition of this oldest race allows it to remain that way. The flats, the greatest misnomer ever, is where you'll lose if the skis aren't running. Trees create an even greater impression of speed. The Hanegschusch, Wengen is accelerating towards the race. Austrian hole, the Swiss delighted to give it that name after a number of Austrians fell but weren't hurt quite a few years ago. Bumps, rolls, ice, and a finish in sight. The longest race in skiing. And at the top, they're ready for the 59th Laberhorn International.
A lot of tension in the start-up today. The last World Cup downhill before they go to Vail for the World Championships. At the top of the Laberhorn, number one, Michael Meyer. Ninth yesterday, the only downhiller who has been in the top 15 in all the seven downhills so far this season.
The first runner is started.
The race down from the top. So here's Meyer with the hunch off coming up. Despite his strength and his size, he was a little slow over this section yesterday. Here it comes. Big jump, and he goes too far over to the right as we look at it. Now the Minge canter. And the big swinging right-hand turn. Meyer now down to the Hanek Schuss. 154.63. A lot of check times on this Laberhorn run. Over 2.5 miles, dropping 3,000 feet from start-up to finish line. Fourth best downhiller of the season. Behind Bernsberger, Hoeflenner, and Giardelli. That's the ice of the S. Oh, and a little mistake there. He nearly caught the gate. The jump into the finish not as big as it has been in previous years. 2:29.75. The winning time yesterday of Giardelli, 2:26.54. And Meyer making a couple of mistakes at least. This was the first one. The entrance to the Hunshof, and he had to work so hard to get back online there. A sheer relief when you make it. Vosmeyer, second yesterday. And good there, as he was last time, 800. Oh! Little flick there. Perfect line. This is the only race he's ever won in downhill, and look at that gap. Yes, Meyer has paid for his mistakes, and Vosmeyer is well up. He raced at number 16 yesterday, racing at number 2 today, and look at the gap, 1.34. Giardelli thought he was absolutely safe and held his breath when Vosmeyer came down yesterday. This is where he lost half a second yesterday through this last section. He was identical to Giardelli on the last check, lost it through this section. He'll beat Meyer's time easily and beats it by 1.59. Vosmeyer has set them something to go for. Doesn't look that happy about it. Bernsberger. Oh. A lot of air under the skis there. And Bernsberger hasn't appeared further down the mountain, so he's got into trouble. That's the first time Bernsberger's ever failed to complete the Laberhorn run. Rob Boyd of Canada, excellent run yesterday in seventh place after his sixth in Kitzbühel. And good there. The comparison against Vosmeyer. Changed his line from yesterday's race. He was two over to the right last time. This is difficult again today. Boyd lower down the course. The news of Brian Stemmel, by the way, as Boyd is second there. Brian Stemmel, the Canadian who crashed in Kitzbühel. Much better news. He's sitting up in hospital in Innsbruck, and his parents have come over to see him. So that's encouraging. Meanwhile, Boyd. Just a 20th. Canadians in good form on the build-up to Vail. Belchik raced well as yesterday as well as Boyd. Now it's possible. 26 and exactly the same as the gap in that last check time. Rob Boyd goes second to Vosmeyer by 0.2.
Time for Rob Boyd, 2:28.36 seconds this time so far.
Very good running Kitzbühel, brought the confidence back, what he was lacking early in the season. Höfflener, who won here in 1985, 12th yesterday. It's about the same as he was yesterday. That top section, he hasn't been taking too well. No Austrian in the finish area yet. So Höfflener, two wins this season, and up there, Höfflener has found speed on the glide section where the race has been won and lost so many times, up on Vosmeyer. Now this is what the Austrians need, with Wernsberger having fallen and Höfflener is still up. Also a rumour that Leonard Stock will not start today. Leonard Stock drawn 15, he's been limping since the training fall and he's a doubtful starter. Höfflener takes the S. He was up on Vosmeyer at the checks. And he's down at the finish line, 300th. He lost quite a little bit there over that icy S section. So Vosmeyer still has it, with Höfflener going to second place, Boyd of Canada third. But Vosmeyer has to wait and wait. There are a lot more to come. Peter Müller has decided to start. Now this time will be interesting. He said the push-out from the start would be difficult with the injured hand. Yes, and you can see it slow. Now he's got a lot of work to do now. He'll be trying not to think of yesterday. And yesterday it went wrong right here. Oh, a little open through it. It's got the line right. What's he found over this section? That's a long way down. One here in 1980. He's had a third, a fourth, and a fifth here as well. And of course, the famous fall right on the finish line. Not finding anything at the moment. This is not the best preparation for his defense of the World Championship. He's through and over the line, but he won't hold fifth place, surely. Over 2 seconds down. So Müller has to work on something before he goes to Vail and while he's there. Now, Giordani. He wasn't the quickest over this point yesterday. He found speed all the way after that, but he's the quickest today. His drive through these corners and the S's and the speed he gets out, one of the features of yesterday's race. Good line again. It's become the top downhiller. And my goodness, look at this. 1.75 seconds almost. Vosmeyer will have seen this. Vosmeyer leading from Höfflener. But this run of Giardelli's as good, if not better, than yesterday's. still up. Virtually the same margin. Record time yesterday, 2:26.54. Tremendous line. All the confidence, all the ability. Little jump into the finish there. He's winning, 2:40. It's about a second faster than yesterday. I am number one, he says. Peter Muller, the first to congratulate him. What a ski racer he's become. Always was technically good. He's now an amazing downhiller. Daniel Mara, third yesterday, a week before a winner in Kitzbühel. Second, but look at the gap. Zubrigan will be next. Zubrigan, as you know, still not well. So Mara really is the big hope today. Still second. Those rollers are bigger today than they were yesterday. Mara had good line yesterday on this. Off the brushes, it doesn't matter. He's through the gate, but he'd have lost time there, took the long way round. Still holds that second place, but second by over 2 seconds. He knows where he went wrong. He lost a lot there. Giardelli, Luxembourg. This man, Mara, Switzerland, second. Bosmar, West Germany, third. Zubrick. Slow at the top section here yesterday. And not very quick again today, by comparison. Takes that superbly. The jumps are his big worry in downhill racing at the moment. Brigand's speed comes from the turns and the way he comes out of them, and he's picked up a little there. But how on earth is any going to find 1.3 seconds on what's left of this mountain? He's lost a little more now. This is threatening Bosmar's third position. Brigham is going to go to the World Championships without a World Cup downhill win this season, but he goes up into second place. Takes it away from Mara. So we've got Switzerland second and third now. Giardelli still leading. The gap is nearly 2 seconds. You're wondering about records. The biggest gap in ski racing was over 4 seconds when Klammer won here. Graham Bell now, 29th yesterday in 2:31. Slightly more over to his left on the Hunshoff than he was in the first race. Squashed that little pre-jump on the Minch Canter. Just beaten by his brother Martin yesterday. 22nd at the moment. Slightly open on the entrance to the S. Better line through it, though. Beginning to get a little high in the shoulders over the last three or four races. Gustav Early, Switzerland. Switzerland second and third with Zubrigan and Mara, and Early is doing well on the top section. Up early in fourth place with Switzerland, Zubrigan and Mara up there second and third. Giardelli leading, and Early with a start number of 30 has found speed over the flat section. Now onto the S, 19th yesterday. Good line through there, and Early is having the run and goes for it. Tremendous. Switzerland has second, third, and fourth. Giardelli on a Brooklyn. Looking for Martin Bell. Here he is. 28th yesterday in a time of 2:30.98. Graham's time today 2:33.30. Totally different line than all the Swiss take through the S. Good through that section, but 2:32.11 still beats Graham and beats him for the second time in 2 days. This is Ralph Socher of Canada. Canadians have had another good day here so far. He's new this season. Socher's going on the Minch canter. Well, that's a shame because he had a good run yesterday, held in high regard by Glenn Whittell, the head coach of the Canadian men's team. Got out of control there, was opening up very much, and then on the landing just slid away. It is very, very steep just above that railway line there. Loses the ski, which crashes into one of the control gates. And it's very hard and icy there as well. One of the places it's kept icy. Socher's had a bad tumble.
Hey, Mom, I'm okay.
So Giardelli does it again. Two wins on the Laberhorn in 2 days, following on from his success in Kitzbühel. And just look at the way he did it. Beating Perman Zurbriggen, who equals his best result of the season. But he beats Zurbriggen by nearly 2 seconds. The Swiss have done well, second, third, and fourth. A good send-off to the World Championships. Another bad day, really, for Austria.
Mark, I don't think even you could have believed this could happen, could it? 2 wins, 2 days?
Yeah, I was maybe surprised that it went so easy. For me, I had a lot of reserves after the training. I knew that I will be a favorite for the top three, but that I win twice in a row, it's very good for me. And I hope I can keep this form until the end of the season.
The margin of the win today was remarkable.
Yes, this is one of the most difficult downhills in the world. And when you have a run without any mistake, and when the material is also perfect, then you can make a big distance.
What makes the Laberhorn so difficult?
It is. There are a lot of very difficult turns and jumps, and also the length of the downhill. After 2 minutes, you start to become tired, and then you start to make little mistakes, which cost very much time.
Can you compare your two runs of today and yesterday? Was there much difference?
No, it was not very much difference. Just in the middle section, I had a little mistake yesterday, and I made a very good section there, and so I skied a faster time than yesterday.
Well, it couldn't be a better build-up to go into the World Championships. You must be extremely happy the way this form has suddenly come right for you.
Yes, I would be more happy when I would have two or 3 days more time to recover a little before the championships, but it is very hard and tough, and I hope I can stabilize my form until the end of the season.
It's a pity that the red, white and blue on his cheeks doesn't mean he skis for Great Britain, but this is how they stand in the World Cup as they leave for the World Championship in America. Giardelli, the best of the season, his Kitzbühel win and the first ever double Wengen, one of ski racing's biggest stories. With this Wengen weekend, we've also got the last slalom before the championships. 14 years ago, a Swedish teenager came here and won the race, only the second of his then short career. Today he's back again, but it'll be for the last time. Ingemar Stenmark is now 32 and the all-time record holder in the sport. He's won 2 Olympic gold medals, 3 world championships and 85 World Cup races. The millionaire has decided this season is the time to finish.
It doesn't matter for me if I don't win or if I don't make good results. Skiing is, as I said, I like it very much, but it's not so important anymore.
And it's just as well when you see what's happened this Sunday afternoon in Wengen. First of all, Stenmark watched Armin Bittner on the first of the two runs. Bittner is the top slalom skier of the season. He's won the last two races, never out of the top four. He's the World Championship bronze medalist. But there he straddles the gate. about two-thirds of the way down the course. Bittner carries on. The ruling is that if you know you've straddled a gate, you should pull up. Bittner, of course, was disqualified by the judges. Here's where it happened. It's a tricky course. There's very little snow on it. Coming over that rise, he hit that pole hard, and there the skis each side of the pole. The favourite was gone. Stenmark had been drawn number 20 on this first run and never looked comfortable, and he was to go out quite early. An inglorious exit from his skiing career in Europe. Three times the Wengen champion, but his last win came in 1977. Well, on that first run, Neerlijk of Austria had gone 3/100ths faster than Tomba. Neerlijk and Tomba, the best. In the second run, there are 56 gates on the course. It's been set by an Austrian. A little bit of fog over the Jungfrau course after the brilliant sunshine of the last 2 days. And the man of the last 2 days, Giardelli, going on this second run. Six on the first run. 0.8 down on Neerlijk of Austria leads Hugo Leiter. Split time for one of the earlier runners. And Giardelli quicker, as everybody expected. The gate set across the hill quite a lot. They've struggled to find enough snow even to run it. That's a difficult transfer there. 49.71, Giardelli has to do this run in to go into the lead overall. The times of the two runs added together, and he does by nearly 3/4 of a second. So Giardelli leading in the slalom after the two wins in the downhill on the Labrador. Lost his slalom championship lead last week to Bittner, who went on that first run. Ole Furuseth of Norway, just 22. Stan Gassinger of Austria has already skied out. And Furuseth fourth on the first run. He was 3/100ths quicker than Giardelli. The first time down. Having a very good season. Never lower than ninth, 2/4ths and a fifth, and fourth in the World Cup Slalom Championship. And a little slow there. Used up that small advantage he had on the first run on Giardelli. Very difficult indeed, because they're coming down all those little lips and mounds. 49.04, he's got to do it in, and he's missed it by 3/100ths, but a very good second part by Furuseth, the young Norwegian. So he goes second, Giardelli still leads, and here's Hubert Strolz of Austria. The Olympic Games gold medalist in the combined event, silver in the giant slalom, fourth in the supergiant. Third on the first run, 0.5 down, one of two Austrians in the last three to race it. He was 0.3 faster than Giardelli, current leader. Only second at the split. That means he'll still be up on Giardelli on combined time if he keeps this going well. Strolz hurt an ankle just before the start of the season, but seems to be fully recovered. 49.31 to take the lead from Giardelli. And he's there surely, and he is. There'll be no hat trick in Wengen for Giardelli. Strolz has gone into the lead. There's still another Austrian to ski, but there's also Alberto Tomba of Italy. Giardelli, a smile on his face. It's been the greatest weekend of his life. And here's Tomba. Still only with one slalom win this season. That was early on in Italy, after six last season. Second on the first run. Neerlijk still to come. He's got half a second in hand on Strolz. Desperately needs to do well here to get himself in the right frame of mind to go off to Colorado. Yes, he's well up. Look at that. And with the advantage he had on Strolz in the first run, this could be a big lead. And only one man to come, another Austrian Neerlich. Tomba going for his second win of the season. He's fallen on two of the slaloms. 46 and well inside. Look at that gap, 1.68 seconds. He leads by the Tomba salute, the one he'll hope to reproduce in Vail in the championships. And one man can beat him, Rudolf Neerlich, the 22-year-old blonde Austrian who's waiting at the top of the course. The best on the first run, but by only 0.03 seconds. He's never won a slalom race. He's only produced one result this season, that was a third in Kitzbühel. More of a giant slalom man. Tomba leading from Strolz from Giordani. A very slight advantage on Tomba in the first run. Oh, and he's a quarter of a second down there. So all the advantage is gone. And Neerlich will have to produce something remarkable now over this last section. Little mistake there. He's trying. Totally different skier from Tomba. 47.98. He's got to cross the line, and if he's going to do it. But he was well done. Oh, and he has! 0.02 seconds. Neerlich goes through. He skied that bottom part remarkably. It was deceptive, and Tomba is beaten again. Neerlich wins the first slalom of his career. And Austria have really now got something to shout about after the disappointments of the downhill game. Rudolf Neerlich, Austria, beats Alberto Tomba. So here it is, the result of the last slalom of the European season. Austria 1-3. Tomba in the middle. After six races, Giordelli has regained his lead in the championship. He shares it with Bittner. Tomba is third. And with that and the sunshine and a remarkable weekend for Mark Giordelli, now the outstanding race of the season, we leave Europe. We're not going all the way by train because the next stop is Vail, Colorado, United States of America. Next week at 5:45, we'll be there with the challengers and the title holders. One chance in 2 years to become champion of the world.